U.S. battleships is stranded, drifting into enemy territory. Wood and Payback need assistance against 4, and make that 5 enemy aircraft.
Are you gonna respond? They need our help.
We may be outnumbered, but you're the best of the best.
We need to get out there and help them before they're all dead, Vsauce 3.
Hi, I'm Jake, and before I found myself in a high-stakes dogfight while questioning my abilities, I had 2 loves in my life, science and movies, so I decided to put myself in one of my favorite films, Top Gun, to find out if you could survive the physics of flight and Newton's 3 laws of motion. Since I've joined the Academy, I've taken my body to its limits, and also I'm suffering from a severe emotional breakdown after my maverick ways cost me the life of someone very close to me.
Come on, man, get your head out of the clouds.
I'll try to pull it together. Well, figuring out if you could survive the extreme limits of G-force, defying the laws of gravity, and breaking the sound barrier with just your body.
One's been hit! One's been hit!
Could you survive Top Gun?
I could outfly any one of you clowns.
Keep it in your cockpit, Woody.
Thanks. Yo, Jake, catch.
Jay Ellis. What are you doing here?
I really enjoyed learning to fly while I was making the movie. Really want to know more. You know what they say, knowledge is power.
Cool, cool. Well, you can learn all you want, but you're not gonna beat me, Jay.
The call sign is Payback. Vsauce, what is that, 3? Like 3rd?
Come on, fellas, let's make nice. We're the best science pilots in the whole country. Here to fly planes, sing at bars, make bets on...
You are the top 1% EduTuber aviators. The best of the best. But we're gonna make you better. You will compete against one another in science combat missions. And whoever comes out on top will get their picture up on that wall. Actually, it's the wall past that one, just down the corner. You go down some stairs to the bathrooms. Okay, look, anyway, we will teach you to fly right up to the edge. But first, you gotta get it in the air. But that's simple. Or is it?
Or is it? I'm gonna get my photo on that wall.
You think you can do this on your own? Be my guest.
So, the basics of flight. Everything that it takes to get an enormous hunk of metal into the air and keep it there, while gravity tries to bring it back to the ground, can be described by Newton's 3 laws of motion. But I think there's a more appropriate place to demonstrate this. The first law states that an object in motion stays in motion until acted upon. Gravity and drag are 2 forces constantly acting on the plane. So to stay in motion, the plane requires thrust to counteract them. In a jet, if thrust and drag are equal, the aircraft holds a constant speed. But if thrust is increased, that is acceleration, bringing us to Newton's second law, which states that the acceleration of an object is connected to 2 things. Force and mass. A forceful arm is enough to accelerate the ball, but what pushes a plane forward? Aircraft turbines take in air at the front, compress it, and inject fuel into it, then ignite it to heat up the air. That hot air then gets released out of the back and produces enough force to accelerate the mass of the plane forward and into the air. Which brings us to Newton's third law. Every action has an equal and opposite reaction. In this case, the hand hitting the volleyball causes it to move away from the point of impact, soaring through the air like a flying plane. Speaking of which, there's an even cooler example of this that is crucial for getting that plane in the sky and keeping it there. On a plane, wings are actually angled and deflect air downward, Since the wings push down on the air pushes up on the wing. This causes lift, keeping an airplane in the air, even an enormously heavy jet.
Vsauce 3. Game time.
You know, Payback, I like to solve my problems in the air.
Vsauce 3 and Payback are tied, and these final training missions will determine the best science aviator.
Today's the day I get my picture on that wall, Ducky.
Hey, don't get too cocky, Vsauce 3. At the end of the day, we're all on the same team.
Set,
banking!
Oh, we're turning way too fast. We're generating too many G's, man. We're gonna pass out.
You know, that's actually pretty interesting. Ugh. Why do we feel such immense G-force when we're turning? Let's find out. Banking!
Why did I sign up for this?
G-force, or gravitational force, is a representation of the weight that your body feels from thrust, turning, or gravity. And you're actually experiencing G's right now. One G is what you experience right here on Earth when you're standing. That is 9.81 meters per second squared. Now, how do you experience more? Well, there's roller coasters, there's fast cars, but I want to experience even more than that, which is why I have this jet. Engaging in extreme maneuvers, the Blue Angels flight demonstration team is routinely subjected to upwards of 7 G's. So flying along with them is the ideal way to illustrate what happens to a human when subjected to extreme G's.
Here we go, canopy's coming down. Start taxi now.
Side note, I'm chewing gum because the pilots told me it would help with nausea and equalizing my ears. It didn't.
You ready? Here comes the afterburns, a little bit of a kick in the pants. There's 100 knots. Now we're 200 knots. All right, man, you ready to go flying?
Do it.
All right, man, here we go. Ready, hit it. Hey, we're going up, man.
I'm not gonna lie. I spend most of my energy focusing on not passing out. So I'm going to rely on an expert to explain what's happening. The Blue Angels flight surgeon.
In your body, G's are all about your circulatory system. So if you have an increase in G-forces, the blood all throughout your body, especially in your head where your brain and your eyes are, it's gonna start to pull it down to your feet.
It starts making your stomach not feel so great.
Yep.
So
when that pooling starts, that's about 1 to 3 G's. So the blood's gonna start draining out of your head.
Like I just feel my flesh pulling off my arm.
From about 3 to 4 G's, you're gonna actually start losing your vision.
Go ahead and squeeze those legs a little bit. There's 4 G's.
After 5 to 6, all the blood in your brain will pool down to your lower body and you pass out.
Your body has an actual 3 to 4 seconds of G tolerance to it before the sustained G will start getting you.
Passing out is what we call G lock, so gravitational loss of consciousness. So in order to keep that pressure and the blood pushed up into your brain, you'll have to squeeze your body very tight, starting from your lower body, working your way up.
And here comes the G. I'm gonna pull up the 6 G's there.
You're also gonna wanna do something called the hic maneuver. With your voice, you're gonna say the word hic, which is gonna close your glottis in the back of your throat to keep that blood pressure in your head.
There's 4.
Almost. Lock up, baby. Lock up, baby! Woo!
Payback's down. You're one step closer to winning Top Gun.
Yes!
We gotta preserve this moment for posterity. Ah!
Heads up, fellas. Oh, good to see you.
Watch the birdie. Jeez, I quacked myself up.
I win. Better luck next time. Oh, I love taking that guy down.
Yeah. Hey, put your mask on. Hypoxia could kill us.
Nah, I mean, I know all about lack of oxygen. Also, We got a little bit of time before hypoxia makes you pass.
Vsauce 3? Vsauce 3, your mask! Your mask! No, 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 no. Engine 1 is out. Engine 2 is out. Mayday, mayday, we're going down. Oh God. Altitude is 7K, dropping fast. We're in a spin. Vsauce 3 is passed out. Eject, eject, eject.
Ducky, come on. Tower, this is Ghost Rider requesting a flyby.
Negative, Ghost Rider. The pattern is full.
I don't know, Vsauce 3. This isn't a good idea.
Sorry, Ducky, but it's time. I feel the need. The need for speed! What's your problem?
You. You're everyone's problem. You know, you may think that rules are guidelines, but when you break the rules of science aviation, someone gets hurt. You're dangerous.
Yeah. Pay back. I am dangerous.
And cut.
Nice.
Jake, that was great. I'm really getting that you feel terrible about killing your best friend and you've lost your way, but could you guys be a little more sweaty? All right, good. Let's go again.
And when you break the rules of science aviation, somebody gets hurt. You're dangerous.
Yeah. Pay back. I am dangerous. And when?
I don't care if you lost your passion for science, Vsauce 3. As your commander, I order you to keep flying the training missions. This is your final training mission. Payback has pulled into the lead, but top honors are still up for grabs.
You all right, Vsauce 3?
I feel the need. The need for speed.
But should I? Vsauce 3! To go supersonic, you need... Actually, let me just show you what you need.
Supersonic literally means going faster than sound. It's also known as breaking the sound barrier, which is really just pressure waves in the air that pile up in front of a plane the faster it goes.
And you ready to go supersonic?
That sonic boom you just heard occurs when an object, in this case the plane, travels faster than the sound waves it is generating. The sound waves created by the plane continue to pile up on top of one another, creating a path of super energetic sound waves. Breaking through those sound waves creates the sonic boom. An interesting thing happens when you break the sound barrier. People watching it will hear it, but for you traveling, it will be absolutely silent. Because you're literally flying faster than the speed of sound. I experienced firsthand that breaking the sound barrier in a jet doesn't really affect your body. But it got me thinking, what happens to your body without that protection? During safety tests in the 1960s, Air Force Colonel John Stapp reached land speeds in excess of 1,030 kilometers an hour. On a rocket sled. That's the closest any human has reached on the ground and without protection. But because of what he did, we can get a pretty good idea of what happens to your body without protection, even when getting close to the sound barrier. Colonel Stapp experienced multiple broken ribs, fractured his wrist twice, had the fillings ripped from his teeth, and suffered bleeding in his retinas that caused temporary blindness. So it's best to do it in a jet.
Vsauce 3, this is no longer a training exercise. We have 5 bogeys. This is the real fight. We need to work together. Do you copy Vsauce 3?
Vsauce 3.
Copy.
Vsauce 3 engaging. I've got your 6, Payback.
Not a minute too soon, Vsauce 3.
Come on. Lock up, baby.
I got you.
Yeah, got him.
That's what I'm talking about, baby.
Here to make things dangerous, Payback.
Vsauce 3, bogey on your tail.
I see him.
What are you doing? We're slowing down. We're gonna hit the brakes. He'll fly right by.
You're gonna what? And there he goes. Now I've got you. Locking in.
Splash 2.
Let's go.
I've got one on my tail, Payback. Get him off me.
Splash 1.
The remaining bogeys are retreating.
Woo!
Yes.
Yeah.
Woo! We're coming home.
You are still dangerous. But you can be my science wingman anytime.
No, Payback. You can be mine.
Vsauce 3. Payback may have won the Top Gun trophy, but with a demonstration like that, Jake, you can have your choice of any duty. What are you gonna do next?
Well, sir, I was thinking about teaching others the joys of science.
At Top Gun? God help us.
Yes, sir. And, as always, thanks for watching.
This season on System.
Oh no. Come get some.
Let's make me hypothermic. Tear this body apart.
Oh, the need for speed.
I don't think you're gonna survive this one.